Welcome to FISC, Financial Strategy Consultant. This is reading number 30 of CFA Level 3 curriculum, where we are going to study about the estate planning and its purpose. So this reading is not very difficult, but it is something a bit different from what we actually study in the CFA curriculum. And that's why some of the terminology might be difficult for you to understand and remember. So let's begin. First, we understand what is estate. So whether you have a stock portfolio, a bank savings account, property or buildings, art and culture, like you have investment in paintings, anything which you have a patent of or any trademark which you own, or even a lot of gold or any other kind of metal or jewelry or commodity, all these are called your estate. So what is estate planning? Estate planning is basically the process of passing on or disposition of one's estate. That means passing on of your estate to your descendant or any other person of your choice based on your will. A will is a document in which the testator, that means the person who has the estate, tells that to whom he wants to give his property. A probate is the legal process in which the property pass on from the dead person to the survivors. Now, what happens is that in there would be a case where there is a will in which the thing go according to will and the probate process continue. There could also be a case where there is no will. In that case, it is said that the dead person is intestate, died intestate, means he didn't have any testament. Whether he died intestate or he had a will, in both the case there is a chance that there could be some legal action against that will by the people who felt that they deserve something and didn't get accordingly. So there could be so many court cases, etc. So the poster you can see here is of the film Rain Man, which was based on a similar kind of concept, where the father gave the property to the eldest brother, and then the younger one kidnaps him and try to manipulate him. So in real life, similar kind of things can happen, where people could kill each other or fight legally for their estate from their parents. So that is the case. So many times individual try to avoid this probate process because it is costly, as well as it is going to impact the reputation of the family. So that's why what they do is that they try to do some out of court settlement. So sometimes the person is very prepared even before his death, and he has some kind of joint ownership of the assets, where the survivor, that means maybe his son or his wife, would get the property, the estate. Otherwise, he is having a trust which has its own rules and laws that how it should go from one person to another, or there could be another retirement plan. So in all these cases, the probate process could be avoided or can be substantially reduced. So this is what we had to study in this LOS 1. So please like, subscribe and share this channel, and comment to let me know that how you feel about this video and what I can improve on it. Thank you very much.